So boys, in our yesterday's class, we covered basic, which one is more basic, which one is less basic, about amines. That is basic nature of some nitrogenous compounds we covered yesterday, boys. So day before yesterday, some of the acidic natures we covered it. That means we know which one is acid, which one is more base, which one is more acidic, which one is less acidic. And which one is more basic, which one is less basic. All we know, boys. Now, in our organic chemistry, there are acids, no doubt. What are those acids? Carboxylic acids, phenols, sulfonic acids, one ion. That is a hydrogen bonded with a triple bonded carbonate. One ions. All these are acidic in nature. Now, bases. Nitrogenous compounds. So nitrogen has lone pair. That lone pair donation power, we know. Okay. That means we have some acids, we have some bases. Now what happened when these are involved in the reaction? Is the reaction possible or not possible? So now we are going to discuss those acid-base reactions available in our organic chemistry. Okay. So see here, boys. Whatever it may be, the chemical reaction takes place in our chemistry. Less stable compounds are converted into more stable compounds. That means reactants are less stable when compared to products. At the same time, products should be the weakest acid. Product always weak acid. That means because that is weak acid, backward reaction not takes place. That is what I told at the time of ionic equilibrium. In any chemical reaction, product should be weak. That is a weak acid. That weak acid further not reacts with that formed base and backward reaction not possible. Therefore, no doubt, product should be weak acidic. So that means reaction proceeds towards weak acid. That means strong acidic compound is converted into weak acidic compound. Strong acidic means more Ka. More Ka means less pKa. That means less pKa compounds are converted into more pKa compounds. More pKa means less acidic. Less acidic, no reactivity. That means, so in any chemical reaction, in any acid-base reactions, see here, what is the favorable condition? pKa value should increase rate. That means less pKa is changed to more pKa. More pKa means weak acidic. Product should be weak acidic. That is the first condition, boys. So in every chemical reaction, in every acid-base reaction, the formed product is having more pKa value. So that means reaction proceeds towards more pKa value. More pKa value. So therefore, less pKa compound change it to more pKa compound. So that is the first condition. At the same time, if negative charge is there, that negative charge should be moved from less stable to more stable position. That may also be possible. That means in reactant side, less stable, that negative charge at less stable condition. So if it moves towards another element, there more stable is there. So that means that reaction also possible. That means the second condition is negative charge should move from less stable to more stable position. Negative charge should move from less stable to more stable. So these are the two conditions, boys. First condition for the feasibility of the acid-base reactions. So in reaction, pKa should increase. In second condition, less stable negative charge is changed to more stable negative charge. These are the two important conditions. So either of these two conditions we can use whether the reaction is possible or not possible. So to identify whether the reaction is possible or not possible, either of these two cases we can understand it. We can use it. So not both, boys. Either of these two we can use it. Okay. So let us take some examples, boys. See here. Phenol. pKa value 10. It is acid. When it reacts with base, NaOH is a base. This is acid-base reaction, boys. So is this reaction possible or not possible? That is explained with the help of formed product side. See here, so this hydrogen is acidic hydrogen. After losing this hydrogen, that phenoxide ion is more stable. That is, it is ready to donate that H+ ion. So therefore, so that H+ and this OH- combination gives H2O, and sodium phenoxide is the product. So formed one is, it is acid, boys. It is a salt, it is acid. Okay, this acid has pKa value 15.7. So here pKa value 10, here pKa value 15.7. That means reaction proceeds from low pKa to high pKa. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. This acid-base reaction takes place. Okay, so whether the whether the given reaction is feasible or not feasible, that is explained on the basis of pKa values. So pKa, low pKa to high pKa reaction proceeds. Low pKa to high pKa. That means so more stable, less stable compound to more stable. Okay, next, second example, and one more example. That is a phenol, pH 10 end. NaNH2, it is base end. It is base. That gives a sodium phenoxide and liberates ammonia gas end. So their pKa value is 38. It is 10, that is 38. pKa increase. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. That means the acid-base reaction takes place. So that means when acid-base reaction takes place, so we can identify that reaction by taking either of these two conditions. One should be pKa value increasing side, low pKa to high pKa, the reaction is possible, or and negative charge. Stability of negative charge should be increased. That means here, see here, O-ra. Here O minus, oxygen gets negative charge. That is more electronegative element gets negative charge. That is stable. That is stable. So this is the way to identify so whether the acid-base reaction is feasible or not feasible. Let us take some more examples. Alcohol, third example. Example 3, CH3OH. pKa of alcohol, this methyl alcohol, is 15.5. When it reacts with NaOH, gives CH3O minus ion, Na plus ion, plus H2O. So already we know pKa of water is 15.7. Boys, 15.5, 15.7. That means almost the same pKa values there. A little increase. That means reaction is slow reaction. Okay? So, therefore, this reaction, it is 15.5, it is 15.7. So, slightly favorable. Slightly favorable. The reaction is slightly favorable, not too much any. The reaction is slow reaction. The reaction is a slow reaction, boys. Okay, next. Fourth example. That is one iron rod. I'm taking C triple bond C H end. So for this, pKa value is 25 end. pKa value is 25 end. When it reacts with NaOH, see here, boys. This gives HC triple bond C minus ion, Na plus ion, plus H2O. So H2O pKa value 15.7. This is 25, boys. 25 to 15.7. That means the pKa value decreased. pKa value decreased. The reaction is not possible. Therefore, the reaction not takes place. No reaction takes place. That means our acetylene not reacts with NaOH. Please be conscious. Very, very, very important. Acetylene not reacts with NaOH, not release sodium acetylide component. So these products, this reaction is not possible. not possible as pKa decreases. pKa value decreases, that is why the reaction is not possible. It is very, very, very important. So forward not possible, backward is possible. So forward reaction not possible, but backward reaction possible. Backward reaction possible, but forward reaction, because in backward reaction 15.7 to 25. That means pKa increased in backward direction. Therefore, forward reaction not takes place, backward reaction takes place. Yes, they will give pKa values. You don't worry. Okay? So, all, at least, please keep in mind. No doubt. No need in actual. Which is more acidic, which is less acidic, we know. But my explanation based on this pKa values. Let us take in future, in our further class, we will explain how to identify, sir, is the reaction feasible or not? See here. Now take the question, boys. Question end. That is, question is, find the direction of equilibrium reaction that is forward or backward end. Find the direction of equilibrium reaction that is forward or backward in acid base reaction in the following acid base reactions. See here, boys, example number 1. Please note down those reactions. OH plus CH3O minus anion. CH3O minus ion. Okay. Gives this one. O minus ion plus CH3OH. Tell me, boys. See here, O minus R, negative charges. Boys, when charge is there, less stable is changed to more stable negative, that reaction is feasible. So see here, let us observe this condition. So this is methyl alcohol. This is methoxide. So no resonance is possible. Less stable. But here, phenoxide. Phenoxide ion, resonance is possible, boys. So whenever resonance is possible, it is more stable. That means, so negative charge moved from less stable to more stable situation. Negative charge moved from less stable to more stable. Now, is this reaction possible or not possible? Tell me your side. F or B, forward reaction possible or not possible? Tell me. Yes. Yes. That is right. Possible. So forward direction, reaction. So forward direction, backward direction. So forward direction is possible. And we can apply either of those two conditions, boys. Either of those two conditions. So no resonance, less stable, high resonance, more stable. No need of pKa values. Is there any pKa required? Tell me, boys, is there any pKa required? But we can identify whether the reaction is possible or not possible. Let us take one more example. That is CH3OH plus phenoxide gives CH3O minus plus phenol. Tell me, boys, is the reaction forward or backward is possible? This is reversible reaction. Forward reaction or backward reaction possible? Tell me. Exactly reverse to the previous one ending. Reverse to the previous one. Boys, it is a more stable ending. More stable anion. It is a less stable ending. So therefore, so backward reaction possible. Backward reaction possible, not forward direction. Okay. Next.
थर्ड वन रहा,
SO3H plus COO minus gives SO3 minus plus COOH. Tell me, boys, is the reaction possible or not possible? So, whether the forward reaction or backward reaction, which one is takes place? Okay, they will give, or you can choose. Forward or backward? Forward, why? Because this is SO3 ra, S double bond O, O minus ra. So this is SO3 group end. So more resonance structures, more stable end. Okay, less resonance structures less stable end. Therefore forward direction the reaction is possible, boys. Next, see here. CH3 C triple bond C H, one ion. When it reacts with NaNH2, that gives CH3, C triple bond C minus ion, Na plus ion plus NaH3. Plus NaH3, boys. Okay. So this is possible, and please keep in mind, carboxylate ion also has resonance structures, but less number resonance structures. But sulfoxide has more resonance structures. More resonance structures, more stable. Less resonance structures, less stable. Therefore, product is more stable than reactant. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. Okay. Now this one also, boys. This reaction is also feasible. Forward direction. This reaction also possible. Forward direction as per our pKa value. pKa value. So its pKa value is 25. Ammonia pKa value is just a minute, 38. Ammonia pKa value is 38. So this pKa value is 25. So pKa value increased, automatically that reaction is possible. Okay, next one, any, that is, please note down all those points, boys. Let us take some more examples. That is, fifth one, CH3, C triple bond CH. Boys, it is one ion. Please keep in mind. So methyl lithium gives CH4 methane plus CH3. I'm writing bottom. CH3, C triple bond C minus ion, Li plus ion. So this reaction also possible, boys. There is feasibility is there, forward direction. Next one, ra. That is O minus ion oxide plus CH3 C triple bond CH one ion gives OH plus CH3 C triple bond C minus. Boys, oxygen having negative charge is more stable. because oxygen is more electronegative element, more electronegative element has more negative charge ending. Here carbon less electronegative ending, less stable ending. Therefore backward reaction is possible. That is ion I'm using in. I'm using ionic condition. Okay, next. OH minus ion reacts with HCOOH formic acid that gives H2O plus HCOO minus. See here, boys. It is COOH. So non-equivalent resonance structures. Here HCOOH non-equivalent resonance structures less stable ending. It is HCOO minus. It has equivalent resonance structures and equivalent resonance structures. See here. Equivalent resonance structures are more stable. Therefore, this ion is more stable than this ion. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. Next, eighth one. That is OH minus, when it reacts with ammonia, gives NH2 minus plus H2O. NH2 minus plus H2. Boys, here minus negative charge on nitrogen. Here minus on oxygen. Oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen. Therefore, it is less stable. It is more stable. Because negative charge on oxygen, here negative charge on nitrogen. Therefore, backward reaction takes place. Okay, next. Ninth one. NH2 minus plus H2O gives OH minus plus NH3. Yes, here negative charge on nitrogen, here negative charge on oxygen. It is more stable, just like in previous case. More stable, it is less stable. Therefore, forward reaction possible. Next. Boys, all these points they are asking in advance, Randy. Please keep in mind. Very, very, very important, Randy. All these reactions. Next, 10th one. Alcohol, OH, when it reacts with NaH, that converts into O minus ion, Na plus ion. Plus H2 gas is released. So here backward reaction takes place. Because this one has more pKa than this one. So this one has a less pKa than this one, boys. So pKa values we are using, boys. So backward reaction takes place. 11th one, squaric acid. It is called as squaric acid. Very, very highly acidic, boys. It is squaric acid. When it reacts with OH minus, so this OH minus, this H plus ion are going out, that gives O minus OH, double bond O plus H2O. Boys, here non-equivalent resonance structures, but you can hear equivalent resonance structures and more stable, less stable. Because it is strongly acidic, easy to release H plus ion, that is why that reaction takes place. It is a forward reaction takes place. Forward reaction takes place. Squaric acid. Next. So thioalcohol and thioalcohol, when it reacts with methoxide ion, gives CH3S minus ion plus CH3OH and CH3S minus plus CH3OH. Okay. So here small sized atom, less more sized atom any. So here forward reaction takes place. Forward reaction takes place. We know. So this is more acidic than this one. This is more acidic than that one. It is more acidic. Thioalcohol is more acidic than alcohol any. Less acidic. Therefore, pKa low. Here pKa high end. No need of identifying values, boys. pKa value high. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. Forward reaction takes place. Next. Sulfonic acid. Benzene sulfonic acid. Reacts with CH3COONA. That gives CH3COOH plus sulfonate ion. SO3 minus ion, Na plus ion. Okay, tell me boys, no doubt. This one is more acidic than this one. More acidic means less pKa. It is more acidic. Means less pKa. Less acidic. More pKa. Therefore, forward reaction takes place. No need of pKa values, boys. No need of pKa values. More acidic or less acidic, we know. Based on that, we can decide is the forward reaction or backward reaction takes place. Okay? So, is this clear? Tell me, boys. So, now the concept is clear or not? Whether the reaction is feasible or not feasible. That is very, very, very important. Okay? Let us take some examples. Always reaction proceeds in the direction of weak acid end. That is the meaning. In the direction of weak acid, the reaction takes place. Okay. Next end. I am taking, this is the compound. Now this one reacts with, so not acid-based reaction wise, not acid-based reaction, no need. Or sometimes it is, okay, take as acid-based reaction. Put in. If it reacts with NaNH, why is in all cases forward reaction takes place and possible end? Because this is more acidic, those are less acidic. See here, boys. So these are the hydrogens, boys. These are the hydrogens. Now see here. If this hydrogen is released as H plus, it becomes minus. If it becomes minus, this is going to be aromatic. Therefore, the product should be this one. Aromatic compound is more stable end. H minus end. Minus with lone pairs. Minus with lone pairs. Therefore, that is aromatic end. Aromatic, more stable. Okay, it is less stable end. Therefore, forward reaction takes place end. So, if forward reaction takes place, this hydrogen is released as hydrogen, half H2O. Hydrogen gas is released end. Hydrogen gas is released. Here also, same product. Same product. Here, H2 gas end. That is half mole, it is one mole H2 is released. Here also same end. But the product is NaH3N. So this is gas, this is gas. In one exam, these three reactions are giving boys. So what is the total sum of molecular mass of the gases released? In one exam, in this reaction, total sum of molecular masses of gaseous products. Tell me. So this is gaseous product, this is gaseous product, this is gaseous product. So in these reactions, total sum of molar mass of gaseous products is, see here boys, hydrogen molecular mass 2 plus hydrogen molecular mass 2 plus ammonia molecular mass 17. Therefore, total 21 is the answer end. Molecular mass is 21 end. Molecular mass of the gas, not weight. It is molecular mass. Hydrogen gas is there. Hydrogen gas has molecular mass 2. But how much weight of that hydrogen is there? 1 gram is there. Because half mole end. Half mole end. Okay. So therefore, molecular mass of all those gases is 21 end. Not 20. Ganesh, Girish. Not 20, it is 21 molecular mass. This is molecule, this is molecule, this is molecule. Just add all those molecules, molecular weights. That gives molecular mass. Okay, next. One more example. That is, okay. Here, this is the carbon we are in identification boys, radioactive. Consider that carbon as radioactive. Here, C star is C14 atom. Atomic weight of that carbon is 14. Actually, atomic weight of carbon is 12, but it is 14 boys. This carbon has different isotope of carbon is used. Isotope of carbon is used when it reacts with NaOH, sodium hydride. That gives A plus B. This A gives C plus D plus E. What are those A, B, C, D, E? That is the question, boys. What are those A, B, C, D, E? Tell me. Exactly this one. It is normal carbon. It is radioactive carbon. Whatever it may be, there is hydrogen. So same reaction takes place. Therefore, A must be this one. This is radioactive carbon with negative charge. Radioactive carbon with negative charge. At the same time, hydrogen gas. This is A. B is a hydrogen gas. B is hydrogen gas. Now A converts into C, D, E. What are those A, C, D, E? See here, boys. Resonance applied. Apply resonance conditions. This is our A. Don't change the position of A. Let's start carbonate. This is A. Okay. If this becomes this one, it converts into this one, this is starred carbon boys. This one gets negative charge. That one gets negative charge. Okay. Next, if this is moving like this, this gives this is starred carbon. This one gets negative charge. This one gets negative charge. Okay. Next. If it is moving like this, this one gets, these are resonance structures, boys. This one gets negative charge. that one gets negative charge. Okay, therefore these are, this is C, this is D, this is E boys. These are all possible. These are all possible, very, very, very important. Okay, so that means whenever that anion is coming out, that is in undergoes resonance, that negative charge is migrated throughout that chemical end. So position of the starred radical, this is C, that is a C14, is not changed, but different come. If this is not C14, all are same. Please keep, if it is not C14, it is a normal carbon. If it is normal carbon, all these three are same. Because it is an isotope of carbon, it is entirely different. Therefore, different products are formed. Did you catch my point, boys? If it is a normal carbon, all these are identical. Because it is a different carbon, so these positions are different. These positions are different. So this is very, very, very important. Very, very, very important. Okay? Next. So this is the compound, boys. So this is a phenolic group. Its pKa value is 10. Next, this is also connected with another phenolic group. Here NH2 group. Basic nature is there. Therefore, pKa value a little bit 7.2 pKa value. Here it is connected to COOH boys, connected with COOH. Its pKa value, because more acidic, less pKa, 4.2. This is connected with CHM. Okay. Now, this compound reacts with 2 moles of NaNH2. 2 moles, only 2 moles are supplied, boys. So this is acidic, this is acidic, this is acidic, and also this is acidic, but these are more acidic than this one. That is why please don't consider this. Among these three positions, which of those two positions reacts with this NaNH? Which of those two positions? Let us take this one as first one, this one as second position, this one as third position. Among these three positions, which acidic position, which acid reacts with that NaNH2 base? Yes, because low pKa, it is ready to go to high pKa. It is low pKa, second best, it is going. It is already high pKa, something more high pKa is not possible, boys. Therefore, 1, 2 are involved in the reaction. 1, 2 are involved in the reaction. Now, note on the product, that is, OH, no reaction takes place there. O minus ion, Na plus ion. There is a reaction, boys. NaH2 is there. CO minus ion, Na plus ion. Reaction is there. C triple bond C, H plus. 2 ammonia molecules, 2 NH3 is the product. 2 NH3, this is the reaction. This is the way to predict, sir, which reaction, which acidic group is going to be react. So low pH is there, that is first reacted. Low pH and then something more and then something more. So if insufficient bases are there, if excess of base is there, all these are involved in the reaction. But insufficient base is given to you, so therefore more acidic one first reaction. More acidic one first reaction. This is first case end. This is second case ra. This is third case ra. This is fourth case end. If four moles are given to you, all these four are involved in the reaction. If 3 moles are given to you, these 3 are involved in the reaction. If 2 moles are given to you, these 2 are involved in the reaction. If only 1 mole is given to you, this is the only involved in the reaction. This is the only involved reaction. So this is the way to predict. So which compound is going to be react? Okay, this is very, very, very important. This is very, very, very important. So please be conscious. Very, very important. Okay, let us take one more example. That is this is phenolic, this is OH, this is OH boys. So here 2 moles NaNH2 is given to you, 2 moles NaNH2 is given to you. Okay, now tell me which one is the more reactive. So let us take this one as first position, this one as second position, this one as third position. So which of those two involved in react with that NaNH2? Which of those two involved in that NaNH2? Yes, good. Bashwant, you are correct. That is Sidhu correct. Bashwant correct. Girish correct. Girish correct, because see here boys, no doubt it is phenolic end, more acidic. Therefore, this is going to be react. This OH nearer to this aromatic ring. This is far away from this aromatic ring. So that means this is more reactive ending. So electron withdrawing group boys, this is involved in the reaction. This is electron withdrawing group. Nearer to the electron withdrawing group, more acidic. Electron withdrawing groups increases the acidic nature. Okay, it is nearer, it is far away. Therefore, it is second best acidic nature. Therefore, these two are involved in the reaction. Therefore, the product is O minus Na plus. This is O minus Na plus. This OH retained plus two ammonia molecules. Okay. So now next one. I'm taking this is anti-aromatic compound. This is anti-aromatic compound. Now this one reacts with 2 moles sodium atom. 2 moles sodium. Sodium atom is active metal, boys. Okay. So these active metals also acts as strong bases end. So this is sodium metal, active metal, strong base end. Acts as strong base. Okay. So these are the hydrogens, boys. These are the hydrogens, acidic hydrogens. So let us observe, boys. So what is the product? What is the product? So now I explain to you. See here. This is, see here. So that is homolytic cleavage ending. This one gets unpaired electron. This one gets unpaired electron. Okay. Next, first of all, this one reacts homolysis end. One sodium ending. This sodium releases electron to this one end and converts into Na plus. That gives minus ion Na plus ion. Next, this one has unpaired electron. Second sodium metal. This one gives electron to this one and converts into this one end. Minus ion Na plus ion. Minus ion, Na plus ion. Okay, boys, that is the final product. Therefore, the answer is this one. This is the answer. Why, sir? Because it becomes aromatic. It becomes aromatic. All these carbons are sp2. So, 4n plus 2 pi electron rule is applied. Conjugated system is there. Aromatic. Therefore, so anti-aromatic compound is converted to aromatic compound. This reaction is possible. Therefore, this should be the final answer. This should be the final answer. Okay? Boys, is the concept clear? Did you understand the concept or not? Yes or no? Please tell me. It is anti-aromatic. Less stable ending. Okay, this is aromatic ending. More stable ending. Aromatic, more stable. So less stable compound easily converted into more stable compound. Sodium, that is active metal, ready to donate electron. Those electrons are like this. Okay. So this is very, very, very important. Next, one more end. One more. That is, I'm taking this one. This is the compound, boys. See here. Listen carefully. Listen carefully. See, boys. This is C double bond. It is electron with drawing group end. This is also C double bond. This is also electron with drawing group. This is CH2 group. It is CH2 group. This CH2 group existing between directly connected with two electron withdrawing groups. This CH2 group is active methylene group. Very, very important. Tomorrow we will discuss about this active methylene group. Active methylene group. Methylene means CH2. It is highly acidic end. Therefore, so this is alpha position. This is, boys, this is alpha position to this one. This is also alpha position to this one. This is alpha position to this one. This is alpha position to this one. This alpha hydrogen is highly acidic, boys. So if a methylene group, CH2 group is commonly called as methylene group. If a methylene group sandwiched between two electron withdrawing groups, if a methylene group sandwiched between two electron withdrawing groups, that methylene group is highly acidic. Because see here, for example, C double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, boys. This is, I am taking active methylene group. If it releases H plus ion, this becomes negatively charged end. This is readjusted resonance stabilized end. With this one, at the same time, this is resonance stabilized with more resonance structures are there, more is the stability. That is why this carbon ready to donate that H plus ion to others. Therefore, that is why, so this carbon is taken as, this carbon is taken as highly acidic carbon. That is hydrogens. That methylene group hydrogens are highly acidic. That means if methylene group, active methylene group is there, hydrogen must be removed from. Hydrogen must be removed from that active methylene group in acid-base reactions. Whenever active methylene group is available, hydrogen first coming out from that active methylene group, that should be the more acidic one. So now I'm giving an equation wise. See here. This is double bond O. This is double bond O. So please keep this mind. This is active methylene group. So hydrogen here is more acidic. This is acidic. This is also acidic, boys. These alpha positions are acidic, no doubt. But this is more acidic. So when it reacts with KOH, okay, so this is the hydrogen coming out as H plus. That H plus and OH minus gives minus H2O. So that gives, this one gets negative charge and K plus ion is attached here. Okay. So here anion is formed. Carbanion is the product. Carbanion. So not from here, not from here. So hydrogen first coming out from active methylene group. Whenever active methylene group is there, hydrogen first of all coming from active methylene group. That is very, very important. Next one. Okay, so this two KOH are added. Two KOH are added. Okay, boys, this is 1, 2, 3, 4 positions possible. And among these four positions, only two positions are replaceable. Among those four positions, two positions are replaceable. What are those two positions? Which one is the first one? Tell me. Which one is the first one? Yes, no doubt that should be the first. This is the first one because it is the active methylene group end. Because this carbon, this methylene group is sandwiched between two electron withdrawing groups. This is very, very acidic. Therefore, it is the active methylene group. First, here is the reaction. It is the first reaction. Next, tell me. Second position. Second position. Yes. So, first one, it is first. Two or four is the second one. Either two or four, whatever it may be, that should be the answer. Because both are same position, sir. Now, my answer is... My answer is 2KOH. This one is K plus ion. So this one minus K plus ion. Either this one are accepted. Both these conditions are accepted. Okay. So that is our final answer. That is our final answer. So these are some reactions, boys, towards acids and bases. So which one is possible, which one is not possible? So mostly in advanced level, these reactions are applicable. Mostly in advanced level. That is very, very, very important. Now, next concept is reaction with the strongest bases. What are those? First one is active metals. What are those active metals or alkali metals? That is sodium, potassium, like that. Sodium, potassium, aluminum also active, like that, active metals. Next, hydrides. Hydrides. What are those? Sodium hydride or potassium hydride. These are active metals. So, hydrides and is strong bases. Next, other cases. NaNH2, sodamide. Sodamide. Next, methyl lithium or methyl sodium. Alkyl lithium. This is an example to alkyl lithium. These are all strong bases, boys. So when these bases react with acids like some compounds, so whether the reaction is possible or not, please keep in mind. So note down this first case any. First pointer. That is, CH3, C triple bond CHN. So its pKa value is 25. When it reacts with sodium metal, that gives, what is that reaction? CH3, C triple bond C minus ion, Na plus ion, and hydrogen gas is evolved, H2. That hydrogen has pKa nearly 38 to 39 value. Now tell me, boys, is the reaction feasible or not possible? Yes or no? Is this reaction possible or not possible? Please keep in mind. Yes, this reaction is possible. This reaction is possible. Low pKa to high pKa. Next. So same time, I'm taking CH2. That is a CH3. CH, boys. This is not acidic end. Not acidic. At the same time, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. It is this one also. I'm taking this one, CH3. This is also not acidic end. Because this carbon is in sp3 hybridization. Low electronegativity. This carbon is in sp2 hybridization, low electronegativity. So these are not acidic. Therefore, with this sodium metal, no reaction takes place. So this is the distinguished reaction between one ions and alkenes and alkynes. It is the distinguished reaction between one ions and alkynes. One ions and alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes and alkanes. It is alkene. It is alkane. It is one ion voice. One ion. So this is the distinguished reaction between one ion and alkenes and alkynes. Alkanes. So only one ion reacts with sodium metal, but not alkanes and alkenes. But not alkanes and alkenes. Okay. Next. Next one, question, which of the following compounds, following compounds will be soluble in aqueous NaOH? Soluble means reactive end. So acids are more soluble boys. Okay. So before going to take this concept, I will explain some reactions boys. Please wait. After that, I'm explaining this concept. Please wait. Boys, please note down these points. So which compound involved in which compound? This is the final reaction study, very, very, very important towards your objective exams. See here, first one, CH triple bond CH. That means I am taking one ion ending, any one ion. That means CH3, C triple bond CH. This one possible, CH3, C triple bond, CH3, this one not possible. Any one ion involved in this reaction. First one, when it reacts with sodium metal, that gives these two acidic hydrogens, triple bonded carbon hydrogen. These are separated by the two sodium atoms, gives C triple bond C minus ion, Na plus ion, minus ion, Na plus ion, and liberates hydrogen gas. This reaction is possible, and please keep in mind. That means our acetylene reacts with, it is acetylene. Acetylene, acidic gram, that reacts with sodium metal. Next. This one not reacts. So don't consider this. This one not reacts. Okay. Next, when it reacts with NaOH, no reaction. Just we completed it in our previous class. That is just before this concept end. Next, with NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate, no reaction ending. Okay. Next, with NaNH2, sodium ion, it is a possible voice that gives C triple bond C minus ion, Na plus ion, CH, and ammonia gas is evolved. So these reactions are possible. That means our acetylene, our one ion, not reacts with sodium bicarbonate. Second one. Next, about phenol. Phenol. When phenol involved in reaction, first one, with sodium metal. So this hydrogen is replaced, boys. Reaction takes place. ONA plus half H2O. Reaction is possible. Next, NaOH, because it is acid, that is base, with NaOH reaction takes place. ONA plus H2O. Already we know pKa values. So low pKa, high pKa. Next, with NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate. It is sodium bicarbonate. This is bicarbonate. Na plus ion, HCO3 minus ion. Bicarbonate ion. Boys, this bicarbonate ion has a structure ra CO OH O minus ion. HCO minus ion, this is resonance stabilizer and these two. Okay, this is. Okay, that means when it is involved in reaction, this one gives, this one is coming out. That gives a CO2 plus OH minus ion is coming out. That means whenever sodium bicarbonate involved in the reaction, CO2 is coming out. CO2. OH minus, that H plus gives H2O. CO2 and H2O are the byproducts. CO2 and H2O are the byproducts. So NaHCO3, no reaction. That means no CO2 gas released. Why and why not, sir? Depending on pKa values. Sir. Depending on pKa values, this reaction is not possible. Next, with what is that? NaNH2. With NaNH2, that reaction takes place, boys. That gives ONa plus ammonia gas is evolved. ONa plus ammonia gas is evolved. These are the reactions of phenol. Phenol reacts with sodium metal, reacts with NaOH, but not reacts with NaHCO3. That is a known CO2 gas is liberated. Which of the following compounds liberate CO2? Which of the following compounds not liberate CO2? Sometimes asked, boys, in our exams, both mains and advanced. So phenol not liberates CO2 gas. Okay, so phenol dissolved in NaOH. So because acid-base reaction takes place. Therefore, so phenol dissolved in NaOH. That is, no CO2 gas is released, not soluble in NaHCO3. Phenol not soluble in NaHCO3. Phenol CO2 gas is not released. CO2 gas not released in. Next. Next, that is picric acid. Strong acid. It is a picric acid. Acts as strong acid. Acts as a strong acid. Okay. Now, it reacts with Na. With Na, hydrogen gas is liberated. This hydrogen is liberated. Hydrogen gas is liberated with NaOH. Same product plus H2O. Reaction takes place with NaHCO3. Sodium bicarbonate. Same product plus CO2 plus H2O. Here, carbon dioxide gas liberated. Carbon dioxide gas liberated. Please keep in mind, that means this compound is soluble in sodium bicarbonate and with NaNOH2, the sodamide. Same reaction possible, boys, with ammonia gas is liberated. Ammonia gas is liberated. Okay, picric acid reacts with all these reagents. Picric acid reacts with all these reagents. Next. Acetic acid, it is also strong acid in our organic chemistry. Carboxylic acids are strong acids in our organic chemistry. Therefore, all these reactions are also possible. All these reactions possible. when it reacts with sodium metal, CH3COO minus ion, Na plus ion, and liberates hydrogen gas. Next, when it reacts with NaOH, same product plus H2O. When it reacts with NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate, no doubt it is involved in the reaction, plus CO2 plus H2O. When it reacts with NaNH2 sodamide, boys, the name of this NaNH2 is sodamide. Sodamide, same product, and liberates ammonia gas. So please keep in mind which of the following liberates CO2, which of the following when dissolved in sodium bicarbonate, all these. If a reaction takes place, that is dissolved. No reaction takes place, that is not dissolved. Okay. Now let us take one more example. So these, please keep these conditions very, very important points. So based on this, at least two grids will appear in our mains exam. Based on these 3.34 points. Based on these points, at least two bits will appear in your mains exam, coming mains exam. Please keep in mind. Okay. Next. Now, tell me, boys. Our question end. Now, which of the following compounds will be soluble in aqueous NaOH? That means reacts with NaOH. Soluble means reacts with NaOH. Okay. Questions, right? Our given conditions are alcohol, OH, ascorbic acid, tell me, boys. This is alcohol. Is this reaction with NaOH or not? Tell me, yes or no. First one, YRN. Yes or no? Please, based on your previous notes, just before I complete it. Is alcohol reacts with NaOH or not? Alcohol reacts with NaOH or not? Just check. Alcohol. Is that alcohol reacts with NaOH or not? So alcohols not reacts with NaOH, not that much base ending. No ending. Next, this is also alcohol, boys, not phenolic group. Here, side reaction ending, not possible ending. Not possible. Alcohol not reacts with NaOH. Alcohol not reacts with NaOH. Next, this is phenol. Is phenol reacts with NaOH? Whatever it may be, electron withdrawing group or electron releasing group, whatever it may be, that is a sick end. Yes. This is yes. This is yes end. Phenolic groups end. Scheric acid, strongly acidic. This is possible. And what about this? One ion. Yes or no? Check once again. With NaOH, is there any reaction? No, Andy. No. Next, it is alkene, boys. Alkenes are not acids. Alkenes and alkanes are not considered. So that's why it is also not possible. Next, HCOH, formic acid, nothing but carboxylic acid. Any carboxylic acid is no doubt acid, reacts with NaOH. Therefore, that is soluble. Any therefore, it is carboxylic acid acceptate. This is also carboxylic acid acceptate. This is also carboxylic acid acceptate. This is our picric acid acceptate. This is our phenolic group acceptate. All those are soluble. Any all those are soluble. Okay. Important. Whenever sodium bicarbonate involved in the reaction, CO2 gas is liberated. Whenever sodium bicarbonate involved in the reaction, CO2 gas is released. First, is the concept clear? Alcohols not reacts with NaOH, but reacts with sodium metal, but not with NaOH. Please keep in mind. See here, I am writing here. Alcohol with sodium metal. Yes, RO minus Na plus H2 gas. This reaction possible. And with NaOH, no reaction. With NaHCO3, no reaction. What about that another one? NaNH2. That gives RO Na plus ammonia gas. This is possible end. Alcohol with that possible end. So this is the distinguished reaction between, see here, NaOH not reacts with alcohol but reacts with phenol end. It is a distinguished reaction between alcohols and phenols. What is the distinguished reaction, boys? One reacts, another not reacts. Reagent that reacts with one chemical but not other chemical, that reagent is called as a distinguished reagent. So which one distinguish? Which of the reagent distinguish alcohols from phenols? That is NaOH. Alcohols not reacts with NaOH but phenols reacts with NaOH. So any chemical that reacts with NaOH, so among that two, alcohol and phenol, that is phenol. Not reacted one is alcohol. That is a distinguished reaction between alcohols and phenols. Alcohols and phenols. Okay. Next. Just a minute. See here, boys. I'm taking benzene sulfonic acid. It reacts with sodium bicarbonate. Okay. Next, alaga para nitrophenol. Another one is para nitrophenol. This one also reacts with sodium bicarbonate. Okay. What are those gases released? What are those gases released when this reaction takes place? See here. Tell me, boys. Our question is, the gases released. R. 1. SO2 and CO2. 2. SO2 and SO2. 3. CO2 and CO2, 4, none. Tell me, boys, the gases released in these reactions are? One, two, three, four. Which one is correct? Yes, which one is absolutely correct? Basant correct, Rohan correct. Tell me in both cases, tell me not only a single case. Not only a single case. In both cases, tell me. Ajay wrong. How, my dear boys? Is there any sulfur content compounds? Is there any sulfur containing compound? How this is SO2 is coming out in second case? So that means second case SO2 is not possible. Second case SO2 is not possible. See here, it is CO2 and SO2 simultaneous. Tell me, second case SO2 is not possible because here no sulfur containing content. So therefore, second case SO2 not possible. Only which? Now tell me, among one and two, which one is correct? Among one and two. See boys, so this is acidic hydrogen ending. This is reaction ending. This gives the product this one end. SO3 as it is remained, no SO2 gas is coming out. Na plus ion and HCO3 that gives CO2 plus H2O. Therefore, CO2 gas is coming out. In second case also same. O minus Na plus, it is a para-nitro compound. So that is H2O and CO2. Here also CO2 gas is coming out. Therefore, our answer is both cases CO2 and CO2 are coming out. Option C is corrected. Even though SO2, SO3 is there, no SO2 gas is coming out. SO3 is itself is there. SO3, that is resonance stabilized. That is resonance stabilized. That is why this reaction, please keep in mind, this type of reactions are possible in your exams. In your exams, okay? So this is the end of acids and bases, acid-base reactions, compared to study of acids and bases, boys. Compared to study of acids and bases, okay? Tomorrow we will start tautomerism. Tautomerism. Okay? Thanks a lot. Bye, all.